Hi there, I'm Miles, and today we're going to get you started with your GOM Scan 1. In this Getting Started, we'll be teaching you how to use GOM Inspect with the GOM Scan 1 for the very first time. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead, so let's get started. Now that we've seen how to set up the hardware, let's take a look at how the sensor works together with our software, GOM Inspect. GOM Inspect software always opens with a start screen. Here you can create a new project, open an existing project, open a recently used project, or you can go to the Get Started software guides. Let's start a new project. GOM Inspect is divided into different workspaces. The workspaces are dedicated to certain tasks, such as setup, digitizing an object, inspection, reporting, and mesh editing. As we want to digitize an object, let's go to the Digitize workspace. When the sensor is turned on, the software automatically recognizes it. Today, we want to scan this bike helmet. Inside the Digitize workspace, we can select a scanning template. This gives you preset settings for a defined application. In this case, we choose the basic scanning template. The combination of the calibrated pair of cameras results in this field of view. Everything that fits in this will be scanned with high detail and accuracy. On the right side of the screen, we have a distance radar that'll help you put the sensor in the correct position. If the indicator points upwards, we are too close to the part. If it points downwards, we're too far away and need to move closer. At the bottom of the screen, we see a yellow symbol which indicates that we must do something. In this case, take a scan. You can also open an info guide to help you throughout the whole project. Let's take the first scan. Due to the intelligence of the software and hardware, the software will automatically detect the correct exposure time to scan the part and will also differentiate between the part itself and the background. By pressing OK, we have the first scan and can then continue scanning. Now we can just move the part and take the next scan. The GOM Scan 1 uses blue light technology to scan in order to eliminate most environmental influences. Blue light also minimizes the noise in the scan result. After you've scanned the part from enough positions, you can see that we've captured the entire top of the part and completed our first scan. If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, or if you have any issues with your GOM Scan 1, please reach out to us at support@handsonmetrology.com. For more Getting Started information, please check out our other videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.